Lalu, apa dikatakan? Honorable Sumandiran.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for the opportunity to say a few words on the occasion of the bill titled Registration of Deaths Temporary Provisions Amendment is taken up. This is an important piece of legislation that this government is moving consequent to the Office of the Missing Persons Act that was passed recently. This has been necessitated, as the Honourable Deputy Minister said, due to certain types of deaths that have occurred for which there is no usual evidence, as one would find in ordinary circumstances. And although this act was brought in for different purposes at different times, after the tsunami a similar provision was brought in, and after a period of intense violence that this country had to face, unfortunately, several thousands of its citizens died, it has become necessary to enable the surviving members of the families of those who met with such deaths to get on with their life, to move forward, deal with property, deal with various other obligations, and therefore the ordinary law as to how certificates of death can be issued had to be amended. Now, along with this, the issue of missing persons became a very serious problem. The government, through several means, tried to ascertain the fate of people who went missing. Initially, in 2010, when a lessons learnt and reconciliation commission was appointed by the then government, when that commission held sittings in various parts of the country, particularly in the north and the east, thousands of complaints were forwarded to that commission by the relatives of people who had gone missing during the conflict. Although the mandate of that commission, the Lessons Learned and Reconciliation Commission, was somewhat broader, I think more than 90% of the complaints received by that commission related to persons who went missing over a period of time, most notably during the last stages from the middle of 2008 to the middle of 2009. The Lessons Learned and Reconciliation Commission, in its report, has brought this out and made very important recommendations. Unfortunately, the government of the day, which appointed the LLRC, did not think it appropriate to implement the recommendations of the LLRC. And although several actions were taken to compel, to persuade the government to implement those recommendations of the LLRC, most of those recommendations remain unimplemented. There were even resolutions in the UN Human Rights Council, and I think the country needs to know this, that the UN Human Rights Council did not, in one move, call for investigations of any kind. It only raised concerns and urged the government to implement the recommendations of its own commission, the LLRC. It was specifically mentioned in the resolution that was adopted in the year 2012. Thereafter, it was reminded again in 2013. However, as we all know, the government was lethargic, if not totally unwilling, to put into practice what its own commission had recommended. And one of those important recommendations, or some of those important recommendations, related to the case of missing persons. Thereafter, in order to show that this important aspect of the LLRC's recommendation is being looked into, the then government appointed a commission headed by former High Court Judge Mr. Maxwell Paranagama. The LLRC recommended that a commissioner, an investigative commissioner, be appointed with respect to the missing persons. But what was done was yet another commission which held sittings all over the country and forced, I'm using the word forced, although there was no physical force, but people felt compelled to go before that commission also all over again and make complaints with regard to their next of kin who had gone missing or who was forced to disappear. Now, these relatives have gone before several such fora. They complained to the ICRC, they complained to the nearest Human Rights Commission office, they make complaints to the police station. Invariably, each of those families has a file full of these documents that they have forwarded to various different authorities who they think will assist them in some way to resolve this question of missing persons. And so they went before the Paranagama Commission also, repeated their stories. I myself attended some of those hearings in Mana, in Mulativu, and so on. And I have commented on this in this house as to how those hearings was far less than satisfactory, that people sometimes were asked questions leading them to answer in a particular way. And there were occasions when several mothers reacted to those leading questions. They were invariably asked about compensation, whether they have got chickens, whether they have got goats. And many a time, mothers would scream at the commissioners and say, "I want my son back, I don't want a goat. I don't want chickens, I want my sons back." The conduct of that commission was so unsatisfactory in everybody's eyes that one of the resolutions adopted in the UN Human Rights Council called for a termination of the proceedings of the Paranagama Commission. For some inexplicable reason, this government too continued to extend the mandate of that commission. But I believe it has now come to come to an end, and some of those recommendations of that commission are also being made public. When that commission started its sittings in the district of Kilinochchi, close to the place where the commissioner sat, there was another tent put up, and the son, or a son of the former president, was personally present there, doling out cash to people who were going to the Parinagama Commission to divert them to this other shed, giving them cash and asking them to apply for a death certificate of their loved one. We raised that matter in this house even at that time. People were being bribed to admit that the person who had gone missing and about which they were going to make complaints had actually died, and to accept such death. There was a huge reaction to this, and then that practice of overtly coercing people to accept death certificates was done away with, and people continued to make their complaints. Over 20,000 complaints have been made, even to the Parinagama Commission, the conduct of which no one was satisfied about. So it's tens of thousands in numbers who have met with this fate. And in amending the Registration of Deaths, Temporary Provisions Act, now there is provision to issue a different kind of certificate, and that is a certificate of absence. This is the most welcome move, one about which we would congratulate the government, because by this, firstly, there would be an acknowledgement that a person has gone missing, the person is absent, without forcing those families to accept that the person is dead. There is presumption of death in our law, but that is only when the question as to whether a person is living or dead becomes an issue in a legal proceedings. Then if those people who would otherwise have ordinarily heard of him have not heard or seen him, initially it was for a period of 7 years, it was brought down to a period of 1 year, then there is a presumption of death. That is different, very different to saying that the person is dead. That presumption is a legal fiction for purposes of determining whether a person is alive or not. In those legal proceedings, it's a very narrow compass that presumption exists. But here, people refuse to accept that the person has died. Why? Because in most cases, they themselves handed over that person to authorities. And then if the same authorities ask them, apply for a death certificate, naturally, they will not do that. Their question is, we handed him over to you. When I say authorities, it is the government, whoever the agency is. We handed him over to you. How dare you now tell us to obtain a death certificate? Tell us how he died, if he died. Tell us what happened. You have an obligation to answer. Without that answer being given, we will not accept a death certificate. But here now, there is another option, the certificate of absence. By that, they don't have to accept that the person is dead. But it is accepting the actual state of affairs. The person is missing. In fact, he is missing. That is their complaint also. So therefore, they get this certificate. And I must say this to the relatives of the persons. There is a mischievous campaign being carried out, telling them not to accept certificate of absence. In the Velaile, Kanamal Ponavarhaldia, Uravhalke, Nangal Solavandi or Mukiamana Seidi on Dundu. Our Kanamal Puirkarl and Sandra the Layim, Edika Vendam, Enandral, Ada Edith Vital, Ada Kupuraha, our Maranathi Vitarkal, our Kurti Edavisa Visarna in Nadabara Matadi, Engendra Puya and Pirachar, Mundrungal Matili, Edika Patirkradi. அது தவறான பிரச்சாரம் காணாமல் போயிருக்கிறார்கள் என்று நீங்கள் சொல்லுகிற குற்றச்சாட்டை ஏற்றுக்கொள்ளுகிற பத்திரம்தான் அந்த காணாமல் போனவர்கள் என்ற சான்றிதழே தவிர அது பற்றிய விசாரணை அத்தோடு முடிவடைந்து விட மாட்டாது அது அவர் காணாமல் போயிருக்கிறார் அல்லது காணாமல் ஆக்கப்பட்டிருக்கிறார் என்பதை அரசு ஏற்றுக்கொள்ளுகிறது என்பதற்கான சான்றிதழ் மட்டும்தான் அதைத் தொடர்ந்து அவருக்கு என்ன ஆகி இருக்கிறது என்பதை குறித்த விசாரணை நடைபெற வேண்டும் initially a certificate of absence can be given because that is a mere acknowledgement by the government that in fact that person is not around that is your complaint as well that does not extinguish your right to have an inquiry into the fate of that person And there must be a determination at the end of it whether the person is dead or not, or whether there is sufficient evidence to conclude that the person is dead. And if there is sufficient evidence, which is acceptable, which the family can actually accept, all right, this is what happened, right or wrong, this is what happened, then they will accept it, and there can be closure. There can be closure. They can move on in their life. Other implications of such a death can be dealt with differently. But this amendment addresses the issue of the family knowing the fate of the missing person. If there is no evidence, if it is unascertainable as to what happened to that person, then you still have the certificate of absence, the legal incidence of which will enable you to continue to move forward in life. Deal with property, marriage rights, various aspects have been dealt with. So this is, although this is not the total answer to this huge humanitarian problem, this is something that can be done and that step has been taken so that there would be some solace for those people who have gone from pillar to post complaining for several years and not found any answers to their complaints up to now. I am moving at the relevant time, I will do so. I have given notice of a committee stage amendment. And I wish to say a few words with regard to that. Because of the incident that I spoke about, where people were forced to accept death certificates, the information we have is that several people have taken those death certificates unwillingly on account of various coercion that was practiced on them. Now that there is a mechanism that is being put in place with respect to missing persons, now that a new law has been enacted, now that through this amendment there is the option of accepting a certificate of absence instead of a certificate of death, even those persons who have already obtained death certificates must have the option to exchange it for a certificate of absence and have their cases also investigated. And that is the amendment that I am proposing, which I will move, and I urge the government to kindly consider this. It doesn't change anything. It only extends this relief that you are extending to the families of the disappeared and who have been doubly jeopardized by this coercion practiced on them, to also have that right to have an investigation. If at the end of the investigation it is found that the person is actually dead, then they may be given a death certificate. But to have in the interim the right to withdraw the death certificate and instead be given a certificate of absence in that period of time. When this act is implemented, we hope that this very important issue, the huge issue of people who were forced to disappear, who were made to disappear, who have gone missing primarily during the conflict in the North and East, as it is defined here, but also otherwise, will have a remedy. And it is our prayer that this scourge of missing persons will be totally eradicated from this land. And while the government takes steps with regard to non-recurrence, we will fully participate in that, as we are now doing in the drafting of a new constitution. One has to deal with these unfortunate people who had to face this issue. And so these are some measures that the government has taken, and we urge the House to pass this into law, and I urge the House also to consider